guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we have another really great business-oriented video for you. This time, we are preparing, packaging, and shipping Precut HTV. All right, guys, so let's go ahead and talk about what we have here. I have a variety of supplies I'm gonna go over with you. And of course, there are different methods for doing this. You don't have to use these exact supplies, but I'm gonna talk to you about each one and why we're using it. So first and foremost, I have a sheet of heat transfer vinyl. I've already cut and weeded. Okay, there's my design. Now, a few considerations is number one, handle your HTV with care. And the reason I say that is because I'm pretty rough on mine, and I don't know that you can see it, but I end up with a lot of, can you see that one there? Little creases and things like that, which we know don't make a huge difference when it comes time for pressing, but it can make a difference with presentation. Also, I assume that you're here because you've already decided to sell pre-cut heat transfer vinyl designs. But do please remember, and I personally discourage it, not for any selfish reason, just for the simple fact that even experienced users with their cutting machine can struggle with heat transfer vinyl. So a lot of times, new users for HTV will assume that it's easy or assume that they know how to do it with a home iron, but it is definitely not an easy undertaking. So, you know, before you decide to make that leap, just make sure that you've given that some thought, thought about how it can affect your business, potentially your business reputation, if you receive negative reviews and just that sort of thing. Just really stop and think about it and make sure that this is a direction that you want to take your business. Now, maybe you're not even selling these. Maybe you're just sending them to a friend. All of that is fine. But like I said, just make sure that you give some thought. The next thing that I have is a sheet of, this is a backing from a piece of adhesive vinyl. So it is coated to be nonstick. Does that make sense? So whatever you decide to adhere your heat transfer vinyl on, it needs to be a nonstick page. So this is, like I said, from adhesive vinyl. Also, if you have transfer tape that has backing on it, those are nonstick. If you use any type of heat transfer masking for like patterns, that will come on a nonstick surface. Just make sure you experiment with whatever you're gonna stick this to. This is my go-to, all right? So what you can do is literally line this up and go ahead and let it fall into place. Okay. Now, another thing I didn't talk about is how important it is to keep your HTV clean, because we know that once that sticky side is exposed, you know, it really can attract a lot of dust and debris from the air. It also attracts fingerprints if you handle it a lot. So if you can keep this sheet handy and go ahead and apply your HTV right after you weed it, you will get pretty good results that way. Okay. Let's set this to the side for now. Next, I have two very important pieces. I have a little thank you. Now, I printed this on cardstock. I did not do it as a sticker, but I do love using these as stickers and working with the packaging that way. It adds a little flair. But if you don't have sticker paper, I just want to show you, you can do it on cardstock and it will still look good. And this is an iron-on HTV instruction sheet, all right? Of course, both of these, as well as the SVG, are from designbundles.net, so I'll link those for you so that you can find these digital files. But it basically just goes over all the instructions. Now, make sure you read these carefully, because you may have other things that you want to add or take away, and this comes in an SVG file, so you do have the opportunity to do that. All right. So for example, I personally would like to address the amount of pressure that you need to use with a home iron. And if you're having conversations with your customers, or you know that they're using a heat press and that sort of thing, that may not be necessary, but these instructions are very useful. The next thing that I have is a self-sealing bag. Now, I keep these in a variety of sizes. I use them for packaging up a lot of my goodies, whether it's shirts, whether it's decals, HTV, sublimation prints. I just like to have a variety of them on hand. You can get them very, very cheap. And this is a stay flat mailer. Okay, now whether I'm delivering in person or mailing, I do like to put them in here. And just remember that when you're calculating up the price to charge, definitely make sure you keep all of this in mind, okay? Because you may only calculate the cost of the heat transfer vinyl, but you know, these little things can definitely add up. So now let's get into our packaging. A very important tool here is a straight edge cutter. And I say that because presentation is very, very important. And what I'm going to do is line this bad boy up and give myself some straight edges. Now, not only is this good for presentation, but it is also good because your design will have straight sides. Okay, that can help your customer to position it on their garment or tote bag or whatever they're going to use it for. And also, if you can keep the size down, potentially reduce the size of your envelope, then you will keep your shipping costs down also. So this is our finished design, okay? Super, super cute. And what I'm going to do, now you have an open side and a closing side. One side has the strip you're going to reveal. So that means this is your front side because you're going to fold this over. So you want the sealing part to be on the back. So we're going to take this design. I'm going to slide this inside. Now you notice I chose one that is going to fit snugly. It just looks more professional, in my opinion. And then you'll have to decide where you want to put these. I do like to put these on the back, as well as a business card or anything else that you want to put in here. Now also, you know, I'm talking about sending the directions this way, but you can actually make a YouTube video. Imagine that. You can make a YouTube video and show them, or you can even link to an existing video. Of course, you know, we have videos, and that could show your customer how to apply HTV with an iron. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make this snug, but not too snug. I don't want to crease my design here, but I'm gonna hold this down with one hand, pull up this side, and peel up the plastic that's protecting that adhesive, and slide it down. Now I can just pull it out, keeping the other part in place. That's gonna help me line up and make sure that my sides stay straight and just overall a more professional appearance. Okay, does that make sense? Now, when it's time to ship, all I have to do is do the same thing. I can just slide it down in here. And then what I like to do, now these are meant to be folded over and sealed, but what I like to do too is if you can safely determine where the end of your design goes, you can actually fold this down and again keep your packaging smaller to try to keep your cost down, because of course your shipping cost is going to be based on weight and size. So we have covered most of the basics here. Now, we talked about packaging, we talked about instructions, you know, if you're selling this and communicating with your customer and all that goodness. But what we can't forget is make sure that you are still providing a quality product. And some tips for that, I mean, make sure that you are using a reputable brand of heat transfer vinyl. Make sure that you do testing. Okay, maybe ship one of these to yourself. One thing that's always worried me about shipping with these is the heat exposure, but I have to remember that when I purchase heat transfer vinyl, it is also shipped, so this should be perfectly safe to ship. But, you know, maybe run it through the mail, see what condition it comes in. You also want to make sure that you have sized it correctly. So communicate with your customer what size shirt you're going to put it on, or rather they're going to put it on. And then also, you know, color choices and layering and that sort of thing, because shipping a layered design would obviously be much different and you would want to provide different instructions with that. So I just think really communicating with your customer to make sure that you're sending them what they need and instructions that they need, because this process can be much more difficult than applying a vinyl decal or even heating on a sublimation transfer. So, but like I said, if you have your heart decided on selling and shipping or gifting and shipping this to a friend, then you know this is definitely a foolproof way to do it. And you have a nice little presentation. We have packaged this up professionally. We have a quality product. And guys, as long as you keep all of these tips and tricks in mind, you should have a very successful heat transfer vinyl sale completed.
So guys, how did you feel about our process and tips and tricks for setting up and preparing and selling and shipping these really cute HTV designs? Now, of course, I think they're really cute. I think all the ones from Design Bundles are super cute. And because you're covered under that commercial license, this can be another source of revenue for you. All right, just keep that in mind. So learning all these tips and tricks, and I'm using HTV as an example, but don't forget we already have videos out there on doing this with finished t-shirts and decals, and naturally we have more coming for you around the corner. So if you have any questions or comments, definitely make sure you leave that down below. I love hearing from you guys, and make sure you subscribe to the channel. Maybe turn on notifications, share with a crafty friend. All of that keeps growing our channel and growing our little crafting community here, guys. So I'm going to wrap it up for today, but thanks again for stopping by, and we'll see you again next time.